Thanks for watching. This video is about my Bangkok shop house, and in the first episode I talked about purchasing the shop house, and in this little video I'm going to talk about some of the planning. And it's kind of just on the eve of actual construction and renovation time, so I'll give you a little update on some of the materials I've purchased, things to do with the council approval, some of the ideas, the construction crew and their concepts, and some of the drawings and stuff, and I'll conclude with some show you the 3D model of the renovation that we're planning to achieve. So first of all, let's go and have a look inside, and I'll show you some of the materials I proudly purchased. Machine. There was actually a big sale on Barn and Beyond is one of the big home supply shops here in Bangkok, and they had a really big sale on, so I kind of made the most of the opportunity. So I bought a fridge and a washing machine and two air conditioners at that sale. Now I'm particularly proud of one of my air conditioners. It's got a filter, an air filter, and if you're familiar to Thailand, you'll know that the air pollution is a bit of a problem here. So I'm happy that that's got the air filter in it. But it's also got, it's got a sensor in there that detects when you've left home and you forgot to turn it off, which has happened in my family once before. So I like that kind of a feature. Now I'm also proud of my fridge. This massive Samsung fridge is, I'm 6'1". It's as tall as me, so I should be able to fit a lot of food in. But one of the features, it's got a button on the front of it where I can, at the top is the freezer, at the bottom is the fridge, but I can actually switch those if I like. I can put the big freezer at the bottom and the fridge up the top, or I can turn either one off. So it's very multi-purpose. I can kind of like, if I've just got milk and bread, I can just use the top section and only turn that fan on and just turn the bottom section on. So one of the things I wanted in this home is some good technology and innovation, so I'm proud of those two things. Now we got this bathtub here. Got it for 10,000 baht. Nice and sturdy. I've got two toilets as well. What's over here? I've got some heaters as well. Just show you those. Yeah, down here. So in popular in Southeast Asia is we don't have like a big hot water system, but instead we've got this little kind of a small heater, which basically the cold water goes into the heater and it comes out hot, and you can adjust the heat or the power that kind of heats the water there. So I've got four of these because I'm going to have four different showers, and they were on discount because the box was a little bit damaged. So I got these for about 2,000 baht each. So I did a lot of research on tiles. I looked at so many different tiles around at hardware stores and shop, shops that sell kind of home products, and a lot of searching online as well. And the best shop that I found is called Ceramic, and there's a nice big outlet warehouse on Bangna Track Road, which is actually close to where I live. And it's the best price and the best quality from what I found. So I've got these kind of tiles. They're this kind of wood finish. I'll give you a close up. So the concept with these wood finish, this will be the floor 2 and 3. And floor 2 and 3 is kind of where the bedrooms are, and I want it kind of like a nice homely feel. So if you could kind of picture, I wanted that wood element. So picture like a Muji store, maybe cross with maybe an Apple store, that kind of a wood. So it's kind of white and that wood finish, but also incorporate a little bit of that kind of Starbucks kind of wood grain as well, which is a bit more cozy. So floor 2 and 3, I'm trying to get that kind of wood grain coziness about it. Compared to the ground floor, which will be floor floor one, which I'm here at the moment. And I've got these tiles here. So these are a beautiful kind of a, it's kind of almost like concrete element. And I want almost like a bit of a warehouse feel for floor one and floor four. So I'll give you a close up of those. So the good thing about these ceramic tiles, that tile there, there's actually 16 different types of that individual tile. And the same with these wood ones here, it's not just one pattern. There's actually, I think it's like 24 different types of wood grain. So these are really good quality tiles. Now, my wife and I fell in love with these tiles so much that we bought the same style for our bathrooms, but just the lighter finish. So the concept here in Thailand, I want this ground floor. This is actually where, like where the entry is here. I want to use the word industrial, but a bit rustic, a bit like keep the walls as they are, just the concrete walls. You know, I actually am going to park my Vespa in the corner there. But if you have a bit of a look over my shoulder, you'll see the kind of concept. There's a party going on over my shoulder. And so this neighborhood, you know, sitting out the front of the house with your friends and family, or sitting down below here, you know, there's a lot of shop houses around. So I actually want to keep that feel. I don't want the ground floor to be super cozy. I want it to be a bit kind of bit rustic and kind of blend in with the surrounding crowds. So actually down the end of my street, there's a lot of motorcycle shops and motorcycle repairs. And I want to say there's a bit of a kind of a gang of hoons, which maybe annoy a lot of people, but I actually like it because I like motorcycles. And also when things break down and stuff, I want somebody to come and help me. But the other thing is, you get these guys on side, they almost act like they're my good neighbors. Like no one's gonna come and, my hope is that no one's gonna come and break into my place because they're scared the bikey crew's gonna come and get them. So that's my neighborhood there. I'm gonna make friends with those guys and party with them in the future. I can see that happening. Anyway, so it's the ground floor. Anyway, what I wanted to, I'm gonna show you some of the concepts and the plans that I've made, and for that I'll go and find I'll find a cool spot, and because I need my computer and a few books to show you this next part. So just about the neighborhood as well, full construction to start, we need to actually get council approval because we do want to put a fourth floor on top, so that's kind of what's delaying the progress at the moment, because we're trying to get the plans just exactly right so we can go to the council and get that stamp of approval. Now this is an important stage, mostly because this neighborhood here, there's a lot of renovations that have gone on, and some have gone on without approval. So the word on the street is there's people here complain a lot, and I think it's kind of common all around the world for neighbors to complain when there's a bit of construction. So before we bring in the jackhammers and the saws and all sorts of the heavy machinery, we need to get approval from our neighbors, which we've already done verbally, but we need to get some signed documents, present that to the council. So if anyone does complain, and to the council can say, well, they've got all the right approvals. Here's man here, I can buy myself a broom or a feather duster. If I want for a bit of cleaning, I will. I do need those actually. Anyway, let me show you some of the concepts and the plans in a bit more detail about what we're trying to achieve here in the shop house that I bought. So it could be a bit concerned about being noisy here, which I don't mind on the ground floor, but floor two and three, I do have in plans of trying to make it a bit soundproof so I can get a good night's sleep. My ultimate dream though is I actually play the drums, so I want one room that's really soundproof so I can play the drums here. But yeah, if you're the kind of person that likes a quiet neighborhood, then I do not recommend buying a shop house in Bangkok. But if you're the kind of person that likes a bit of action and a bit of life, shop houses may be just for you, as it is for me and my wife. Who knows if my daughter likes it or not? She sadly doesn't have any say in the matter. I will let her have a little bit of say in designing her room, but lucky she's adaptable and flexible. So I'm back home in the air conditioning, back in my, this is apartment that I've been renting, which is conveniently only 2 minutes walk from the shop house. So I'm back here, and what I want to do now is just talk you through some of the plans and ideas and the concepts. So I got my bag of goodies here. As you can see, this bag here is full of brochures, drawings, and you know, the title deeds and stuff like that from the actual purchase. But I've been going crazy collecting brochures. I've just been drawing so many pictures as well. If you're renovating your home, I recommend getting a few of these sketch pads so you can sketch down some ideas. But needless to say, I've got plenty of documentation and planning materials. So I'll talk you through just some of the highlights, not all of them. I actually consider myself kind of lucky to be doing this in Bangkok, because Bangkok's such a big city. There are actually so many different like bathroom outlets, tile shops, and hardware stores. I'm actually spoiled for choice. There's just plenty to choose from. And the price is pretty good as well. Fortunately, Thailand has a lot of, they do a lot of manufacturing here. So there is loads and loads of options here. And where I'm actually in Bangkok, I'm actually quite close access to most of them. So it's easy just to pop down and have a look. And, you know, I find something online, it's like, I'm not going to have a look at that. And there's this one thing, if you look at a, say, a tile or a bathroom, a bathroom tiles or an actual toilet, and I think, yeah, that looks good. But then when you actually go and see it and touch it and think, yeah, that is right. Well, no, it's not quite right. It doesn't seem right. So I'm very fortunate to be getting this done in Bangkok. Anyway, there's plenty of good things here. The other thing I've been doing a lot of is sketching. So I've got loads and loads of sketchings. Now, the benefit of doing this for me is when I'm actually drawing these pictures, it really helps them kind of think through. It's like, you know, if I'm going to... The toilet's there, where am I going to put the, where's the towel rack? Where's the toilet roll holder? Where's the basin to wash my hands? So if you're renovating, I'd recommend just doing loads and loads of pictures. I've got pads and pads of these, and I, every day I'm kind of sketching out different ideas, and my wife, I've got some new ideas today. So I rolls her eyes and think, oh, more drawing, more sketching. But yeah, I've been doing a lot of drawing and thinking. Now I've been taking this, and then the next stage, I'll show you what I've been putting on the computer, because I've been also searching online for different ideas and concepts as well. And I've shared this basically with the contractor that we're gonna get to do the renovations. So I'll get my computer now and just show you what I've got. I'll try and do a quick version. Okay, so I've got my computer here. I'll just show you through. I'm gonna show you my little slideshow that I've put together for the contractor and my wife as well. I put pictures there, and then I asked, what do you think about, you know, this, and delete that, change that. So it is a collaborative process here with my wife and I, but I'm the one doing the video, so I keep saying I. It's just because I'm recording the video, but it is a collaborative approach. So let me switch. I'm going to do a screen recording here, so I'll just switch the camera now. Okay, so I've got the computer on, so I'll just switch to this mode here. So this is the entry. Now, as you can see, the colors, the grays, the blacks, and the wood, the dark wood grain. But I like those sprinkling of red, because there's actually a bit of Chinese heritage in the area. So I want to actually tap into that. So you can see some like Singaporean style Chinese letterbox, the big temple doors and stuff. And I did live in China for quite some time, my wife and I and my daughter. So we've spent a lot of time in China. So this is a little throwback to China. So this is the entry. I'm looking for some kind of the black. If we're going to use any metal, it's going to be black or dark gray. Whites and grays, I like those kind of those blocks that allow for airflow as well, out the front. So they've we want to have a nice impressive door as well. So that's whether it's a nice big wooden door, and we want it to be right in the middle of the building as a big kind of a welcome. Now, this is actually the entry. There's a market nearby, Talot Wat Phai, and there are a lot of cool shop fronts. So I actually want to tap into this. So you can see two kind of two doors, And then lots of windows too. So we can actually be still part of the neighborhood, which is kind of part of the feel, part of the idea of that street, you know, seeing the neighbors have a party, watching the drivers go past every now and again. But also with a shop house, we've actually got the potential to open up our own shop. So I'm actually kind of treating it's gonna be our kitchen and our welcome area, but it could in 5 years time be our own little cafe. So I'm kind of keeping that in mind when I'm designing that front of the house. We've also got, like, this is the front of the house, but we've got the roller door that we can actually block it all off and shut it down as well. So that's kind of the front style I like. Here's some of my mini sketches, what it looks like at the front. Here's some more sketches of mine and more sketches. Okay, this is the ground floor. You can see I've kind of got the color schemes that I like. So it's that bluey kind of a gray, you know, and the elements are kind of concrete as well. That's that concrete feel, the materials, with some black lighting, and a kind of open and spacious kitchen, sort of bare bones as well. So I like that conduit style electrical work and things like that. So yeah, it is kind of like a bit of a rustic and an open feel is what we're really kind of going for, with the elements of wood as well. So the concrete style and the wood, the two main elements we're looking for there. Go to the second floor, and this is called like the red. I like those these eclectus parrots. One floor we're going to have like a red theme, and the next floor is going to be the green floor. And the eclectic parrot, there's actually the male and the female. So I like those kind of color schemes. It doesn't mean the whole floor is going to be red, but the red is going to be the highlights and the main feature, you know, like bedspreads or artwork that we might put on the wall. Anyway, we want kind of this wood cozy feel and a little bit of homage to kind of the Japanese style of those sliding doors. But, you know, creamy style walls, much like these walls behind me, actually. This kind of a cream style wall with the wood floor and then some kind of like a sliding door. But also, I want that. This is going to be the master bedroom. It's going to be a really big space. So the concept is, I want to be able to open up those sliding doors and let that air flow through. And if we need to, we can close the sliding doors, shut it all down, block out the noise, block out the light, turn the air conditioning on so we can get a good night's sleep. So that kind of functionality in the daytime, but in the nighttime when we want to get our rest and go into the shutdown mode, we can. So I've got a few different styles. That bottom right corner, that is Joey Ramone's apartment. Now, I like that feel with the sofa on the side. And as a musician, I'm always concerned about where I'm going to put my speakers and stuff like that. And so sound is actually very important to me. Okay, the third floor is that emerald green kind of color palette, and this will be my daughter's bedroom. It's actually going to be two bedrooms on this floor. Yes, so the stairwell will basically go up in the middle of the floor, and the bathroom's going to be in the middle, and then the two ends are going to be separated with bedrooms. Now, one of those bedrooms is at the back of the place, and there's no windows, anything there. So that's the idea. I'm going to soundproof that room, put a nice air conditioning unit, and that's going to be our music room. My daughter's learning the keyboard at the moment, and I want to have a drum kit there, so that's going to be our soundproof room. We could also use it for watching movies and stuff, you know, turn the volume up. And my wife and daughter know that when I watch sport, I often shout a lot. So maybe I could watch sport in that soundproof room. Now, the fourth floor is back to that kind of a bit of a industrial kind of a rustic, not rustic yet, industrial kind of a feel. We want to have some concrete walls, but the black electrical, we want lots and lots of windows as well. Now, the master plan, if we can pull it off, is basically to have like about a 4 meter high ceiling. So then that allows us to have somewhat of a small mezzanine area. So at about the 2 meter mark, have some kind of an area where we could potentially put a bed or a study. And that's also going to have a balcony at that front as well. So it'll be like, this is basically our living room. So that's where we'll have the main TV and the sofa and stuff. But it also could potentially be in the future something that we could rent out with its own bathroom. Or if a guest comes, that's where they could stay, in that top area. But it also could be the party zone as well. Like, we've got the deck and then we've got the big floor. Actually, on the mezzanine is where the band can set up. Yeah, I like that idea. Yeah, so this is the kind of feel we want for the fourth floor. Now, the fifth floor is basically just the rooftop. It's just going to be a rooftop with, I like that tile in the corner, that bottom corner there. It's kind of a bit of a sandy feel, so that I can stand on, sit on the roof, watch the sun go down, because I can actually, if the roof is high enough, I can see the sunset in Bangkok. It's too hot to go up there in the daytime, but it could be a really great space at nighttime. And as you can see, some of the pictures here on the right, you can see I've got like, I'm very conscious of the airflow, how we can, you know, utilize and not use the aircon as much basically, but just use that natural airflow to try and keep the place cool. So with a nice high ceiling, hopefully, and nice insulation there, hopefully that will be that deflect that sun, and the air flowing through will keep pushing the hot air out. That's my main concept there anyway. Bathrooms, I've been looking at so many different bathrooms, tiles and things like that, but we've got the light gray floor. I want to have some kind of feature walls, so it could be, I'm tapping into that, you know, the crimson and the emerald green and that bluey gray style for each different floor to have their different, you know, that they're similar. There is that main feature wall, but it's the different color to tap in with the style and stuff. Now, I'm just throwing together some ideas. It's like, you know, is it the square tile or the rectangular tile, the hexagon tile? What size of the tile? I've been putting too much time and effort into this, really, to be quite honest. This is probably the biggest challenge about trying to find the right tiles to match the bathroom. It's not really in my skill set, or it's new to me, which I'm kind of enjoying the challenge, I guess. But anyway, we want it's going to be the light gray floor. Any kind of cabinets, we want that wood element once again. Now, we also want... I want it to be kind of bright, you know, I believe that a bathroom should be bright-ish with good, strong lighting. You know, it's supposed to be the concept of clean. So I don't want it too dark. But if we've got the nice white tiles or the creamy tiles with the one feature wall and the light gray, that should bring about enough kind of light into the place and make it seem clean and fresh, but not too shiny and white. Otherwise, it shows up all the dirt and stuff like that, and grime and mold or whatever it might be. So we want that kind of a bit of a, you know, that gray streak through, or some kind of like a marbled effect. So because I understand from my use of bathrooms that they do get pretty dirty. So just being completely conscious of that. But yeah, I like those wood style doors on the cabinets and things like that. But here, plenty of bathroom ideas. I like the hexagon tile. These are the feature walls that I'm trying to have somewhere on each bathroom. So, you know, when you're sitting in the bathroom, or sitting in the bath, having a shower, or sitting on the toilet, you look at the wall and go, gee, that's a nice wall. I really like that. Now, speaking of which, I've gotten into trouble. I've been laughed at. I don't mind, but people laugh at me. But I have been talking to my wife and daughter about what kind of emotions do you want to feel when you're in the toilet? And, you know, what kind of things do you want to feel? And they're like, what are you talking about? What emotions you want to feel? Anyway, I've been probably putting too much time and thought into this. Now, laundry. We've got a hole in our floor on the second and third floor, so it's a perfect opportunity for a laundry chute. So I'm trying to kind of develop that idea that we throw the laundry and it goes all the way to the ground floor, and that's where our laundry is going to be. Here's some more sketches. So that's my kind of idea that I've been sharing basically with my wife and the contractor. It's like, these are the kind of the concepts, and I keep updating this. Now, next thing I want to do is show you what the contractor has given to us, some of the plans he's made. And also, I want to show you the 3D model that I'm starting to work on, and he developed, and I'm editing it. And so let me just show you that. Okay, so here's some plans. Basically, we've got the entrance here. So this is a folding door that we can lock things up. Now, if I push the door back, we can actually fit a car in there, and it'll be under shelter. I could also put my car there and motorcycle there. We want to have the doorway in the middle there, and then the kitchen. This is the kitchen under the stairs. And then here's our first floor laundry and bathroom there. So this is car space and kitchen. And that's that kind of welcoming entrance where we take our shoes off and stuff like that. Now, the second floor, this is a master bedroom. You can see it's a lovely big space. So the stairs go up. Now, I like this idea, the concept, the stairs go up and then they turn around, and then we enter here to the main massive big space for the master bedroom. And then this walkway here is actually a walk through wardrobe. So this will be all of our clothes here and then into the master bathroom with a nice big bath there. So I really like this concept. Now this door here, I'm trying to think of something different where we could maybe section this part off. So maybe a sliding door so we can put the air conditioning on here and have a good night's sleep. So soundproof and darkness here. But then if in the daytime, we can actually open this sliding area up and let that air flow through and the natural light go through. So that's the second floor. Third floor, we've got, so the stairwell comes up in the middle here. We've got the bathroom in the middle, and this is the soundproof room that I want to put my drum kit in. And this will be our daughter's bedroom with a little balcony here as well. And this is the top floor, the new addition that we're kind of adding on. And basically, it's a nice big party space, really. We're going to put a little bathroom somewhere nearby. But there's a deck here, balcony, and then this big space. So if we can get the ceiling high enough, we'll put the little mezzanine level at the back there. But if we can't get the ceiling high, then it'll just be one nice big space. And then there'll be a little walkway, like a ladder, to get up onto the roof, which will be standing on the fifth floor so I can go and see the sunset. So they're the plans so far. Now let me just show you the 3D model to conclude. Okay, so here's the 3D SketchUp model. I'll just switch to the screen recording now. As you can see, you've got the doors, the folding doors for the entry. And there's at the side there, we've got those. Let me just change the view there a little bit. You can see those kind of blocks which allow for airflow as well, and that little bit of privacy. Now we've got quite a few wires at the front, and we'll need some places for the air conditioning compressors. So that'll actually be a window on the second floor, and that's the master bedroom. And then the third floor will be two bedrooms there. And I think I might make that larger balcony here so we can actually, you know, use it like a balcony. And then up the top, we've got our, like, the rooftop, the extra fourth floor that we're building. And hopefully that can be tall enough so that it can have a nice little mezzanine level at the back and that balcony at the front and a little ladder to go up the top so I can stand on the roof and we can have rooftop parties. So that's the outside. Let's have a look at the inside. Okay, so here's going into the front of the house. So okay, so here's going through the sliding doors. Okay, so this is going through the front door here. Where are we? Yeah, so this is the idea. We go through that glass door. Okay, so inside now, you can see the concept, with the kitchen there, with the kitchen. And the laundry at the back there. If we go up to the next floor, you can see this is the master bedroom with the stairwell coming up, the stairs coming up, and then you walk down that hallway to the bathroom, and that's that walk-in kind of wardrobe space. Then we go to the top floor, which we've got the two bedrooms here. So this is one of the bedrooms here. Okay, and so here's coming into the top bedroom. That's the main bedroom there. So you can see the bedroom there. As you can see, I'm not real good at operating SketchUp, 3D modeling, the CAD software. I'm not great at this. So. Okay, I'm giving up on SketchUp. I've used SketchUp for small things, but not for a house. I need to increase my SketchUp skills so I can actually see what's going on here. But I think you kind of get the concept. So the next stage basically is agreeing upon the plan, and then we can get approval from the council and then work can start. Now, I've been told that construction should only take about 45 days, so a month and a half after we've got the green light from the council, hopefully I'm moving in. So next video I'm going to make will be showing you about the construction. Or perhaps it's going to be me very depressed because we haven't made any progress yet. Either way, I'll update you in the next video.